Watch it, Boogie Woogie Man says, Ringside Wrestling, the real deal. People, don't you dare miss this one. Whoa, let's say. Boogie Woogie Man says, Ringside Wrestling, the real deal. People, don't you dare miss this one. Whoa, let's say.
There's a lot of stuff going on in Ringside Wrestling Alliance, as I've spoke to you about, and I've spoke to the owners and the board of directors about. There's a personal problem going on between a particular wrestler in RWA and myself. And right now, all due respect to the board of directors and to the owners, I appreciate you guys have been great. It's been 4 years I've been with Ringside Wrestling Alliance, giving me my break in the business. And it's been a great run. But right now, Dave Talbot, I really feel I need to step down from Ringside Wrestling Alliance.
Wait a minute. Now, this personal problem that you're having is, it's not just, a lot of people don't realize, but in the wrestling business, whether it's Ringside Wrestling or the big leagues, WWF, WCW, a lot of times there's conflicts because of egos. I mean, some people just get too tall for their britches, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. That has nothing to do with it?
No, actually, Dave, The particular wrestler I feel has stabbed me in the back, which is a big accusation to make, but that's just how I feel and that's the way it's been laid out. And I was upset and I was frustrated and angry and after sitting down for 2 weeks, as you know, I went to Wisconsin for 2 weeks, and I had to do a lot of thinking, and in the thinking, that this is a conclusion that Matt Hawkins has come to, that right now, you know, maybe not forever, maybe not for good, but for right now, Matt Hawkins needs to step down.
Man, I gotta interrupt you. You are the voice. You are the commentator. Matt calls the shots. A lot of times when we go out there to shoot the matches, we never know what's gonna happen. Usually all hell breaks loose. Nothing's ever planned or, you know, laid out like everybody thinks it is. Maybe in the bigger leagues, you know, it's almost like choreography in the bigger leagues. But I mean, we're like the old days, like the Dick the Bruiser, the Vern Gagne days. And Matt, a lot of times, if we have technical problems, he'll come in and dub over the audio, redo the commentary in the editing room, because it takes a good week to do a good show.
That's right. You know,
and there's nobody like you to do that. I mean, I've tried to do it before, and there's been other wrestlers that have been trying to commentate with you, and nobody does it like you. You're like the Tony Schiavone of Ringside Wrestling.
Dave, I appreciate that. I really, truly do, and I know that it's going to upset the heads of RWA, and it's going to upset the board of directors, you know.
And it's going to upset me.
And Dave, and my good personal friends, you know, who stood by me from the beginning, Soultaker, a wrestler at Ringside Wrestling Nights, has stood by me, him and his fiance through thick and thin through the last few months with what's been going on. But Dave, it's time Matt Hawkins steps down.
No, Matt, we still got 2 minutes left here. I don't know what to do now. I have shows, ladies and gentlemen, to edit to the year 2002, and I don't know what's going to happen without Matt Hawkins there in Ringside Wrestling. There's going to be a big void in the wrestling, and I don't know what to do. But Matt, is there any way you could come back in here? I mean, he hasn't left the building yet. He's just left the tape. Matt, come back in here. Could you reconsider, please?
Dave, I don't know what much reconsidering can be. You know what, Dave? I'm tired of this. Okay, nobody. You're right, Dave. Dave, you're right. No one's gonna run Matt Hawkins out of Ringside Wrestling Alliance. Not a particular wrestler. Not a personal problem. Not some chick who comes and hangs out at the shows. Nobody's gonna run Matt Hawkins out of RWA. Because you know, Dave, you turn that W upside down, and it stands for, and it's an M for Matt Hawkins. Because you know, without Ringside Wrestling Alliance and Matt Hawkins together, that's it. And nobody. I'm telling you, nobody's gonna make me run to Wisconsin and hang out there and nothing. You know what? I'm telling you, Matt Hawkins isn't going anywhere. Board of directors, I'm sorry for wasting your precious time, but Matt Hawkins ain't going nowhere. He's here to stay, and everybody in RWA can remember that.
his opponent, the new RWA Heavyweight Champion from Chicago, Illinois, ladies and gentlemen, the Gigolo Johnny Mercedes.
Wrestling fans, Matt Hawkins here in Portage, Indiana, Ringside Wrestling Alliance action. Bear with me. I'm suffering from a sore throat here tonight in Portage, Indiana. I don't know how long I'll be able to keep up commentary, but our senior official of Ringside Wrestling Alliance, Dave Talbot's around, so whenever I can continue, Dave Talbot's going to jump on in there and finish up for me. So appreciate that from RWA senior official Dave Talbot. In Portage, Indiana right now, we've got... Don Spartan, the specialist Don Spartan, against Gigolo Johnny Mercedes as a Dan Van Loon, the senior official of Ringside Wrestling Alliance, if you get my drift, checking Gigolo Johnny Mercedes there, who looks like he's put on a little bit of weight since last time we've seen him here at Ringside Wrestling Alliance as Angel Armani's on the outside, and that's what Gigolo Johnny Mercedes is going to have to keep an eye on, is having to deal with two men out there instead of just one. So he's going to have to pay attention real quick there. And, okay, collar and elbow tie-up and a wrist lock there behind the back. And Gigolo Johnny Mercedes, no slouch in there. Handful of hair there by Spartan pulling him down to the canvas. And Gigolo Johnny Mercedes, no slouch in the ring. He's got great ring presence, a veteran in the sport. However, you're never prepared for two-on-one situations. You're not, especially with Don Spartan and Angel Armani. Okay, right there. Now Gigolo Johnny Mercedes trying to fight back with the wrist lock there. Dan Van Loon, okay, once again out of position there by Van Loon, and didn't see the pull of hair there by Spartan, and that's exactly what Van Loon's gonna have to keep an eye out for, because Spartan, I'm telling you, he's one of the dirtiest players in the game. Has a full arm dragon twist there on Gigolo Johnny Mercedes. Oh, nice reversal there by Mercedes. Okay, winding up on the arm, but pulls a handful of hair right there, right in front of the referee's face, but what's good for the goose is good for the gander, I'm sure. And Gigolo Johnny Mercedes going there for Spartan. Spartan bails out, and Armani's up there on the apron complaining at the referee. What else is new? Okay, right there. Okay, bring in Angel Armani in the hard way. Hey, you're going to get up on the apron. You must want to be involved in the action. And Gigolo Johnny Mercedes, what the was that? I don't know. But Johnny Mercedes, you got to love him. I shouldn't say that. Right there. Okay, now a little chilling there in the corner. And just a little relaxed and waiting on Spartan to come back in the ring and get the action going. Tonight here in Portage, we had a lot of great action going on. Top Stars of Ringside Wrestling showing up here in Portage, Indiana. Yours truly, Matt Hawkins, Dave Talbot showed up. And what show would it be without Matt Hawkins and Dave Talbot? But, you know, I have to tell the promoters about that. Collar and elbow tie once again. Like, oh, man, nice knee downstairs to the breadbasket of Gigolo Johnny Mercedes. Oh, man, open hand chop there to the face, it looked like. Okay, close fist there to the side of the head of Gigolo Johnny Mercedes. Dan Van Loon exercising the count. Mercedes sent for the right. No, nice reversal. Whip into the corner. Don Spartan, nice leapfrog. Comes back, went for a clothesline. Nobody home. Johnny Mercedes pushes him in the corner. Gets him back to the corner. Goes to the second floor. No, nice monkey flip. All right, and I'm going to have to hand this over to Dave Talbot right about now.
Okay, everybody. Dave Talbot here calling the matches because Matt Hawkins' voice is kind of whipped. Don Spartan, wrestling gigolo Johnny Mercedes, and with me, joining me for commentary, if he'd move a little bit closer to the mic, is Black Diamond. Black Diamond, how the heck are you?
Well, after my defeat, I should say, at the hands of the Widowmaker, I don't feel too good right now.
Hard forearm to Johnny Mercedes. Mercedes goes down, comes back with a slap to the face, a couple shots to the midsection, a shot right to the face, that's a closed fist. Brings him back around. Spartan reverses. Mercedes leapfrogs over him, misses a clothesline. It's got Spartan up there. And that'll open you up in a hurry. It doesn't look like he'll be doing any line dancing later, huh, Black Diamond?
No, actually not. I've been in the ring with Don Spartan. I don't think that this is going to keep him down. I think this is only going to make him stronger. The battles that we've been through, every time I've had him down, he's found some way to come back and take over in the match. And that's probably what he's doing right now. He's probably getting some kind of advice from Armani, if not a set of brass knuckles.
Yeah, that's a very good point. Spartan is a wrestler that whose middle name is Dirty Fans, and he can come back out of practically any punishment that he gets dished out to him. He regains his composure, regains his confidence, regains a little bit more stamina outside of the ring. And Mercedes is kind of a little bit of a cocky wrestler. He thinks he has the guy beat when he really doesn't really have a clue of what the guy has left, like Don Spartan. They lock up right now again. Drop toe hold. He's got him by the hair, rubbing his face into the mat. And may I say, Black Diamond, the match that I was in with Alan Scott Cruz, they should have cleaned up that flower a little bit more. Let me tell you, that floor is awfully slippery.
Well, I know what you're talking about there. I think a lot of my blood's on that mat out there, too. If he was rubbing his face, he's probably rubbing it in that as well. Actually, I don't know what the hell I'm talking about, so if you want to commentate a little bit longer, okay. I'm just going to sit here and nurse my injury.
Okay, Angelo Armani is kind of interfering. I don't want to say kind of. He actually is interfering. But Johnny Mercedes, now Spartan's got referee Dan Van Loon distracted while Angelo Armani is plummeting, beating the heck out of Johnny Mercedes outside of the ring.
That's exactly what I was talking about earlier, Dave. That's why Don comes out with Angelo Armani. He knows he can't do the job himself. He's got to have some help on the outside. That's what Angelo Armani's there for, not for support, just to take over when Johnny's on the outside of the ring.
That's exactly right. This could be the turn of the match whenever there is outside interference. Sometimes it's King Bishop, sometimes it's Alan Scott Cruz, Luscious Leroy, Angelo Armani. You never know what to expect from these guys. And as I said, fans, if you're just joining us, Matt Hawkins is kind of gargling with some salt water and some lemon juice right now to kind of get his voice, his vocal cords back in shape, because nobody calls it like Matt Hawkins with the best pipes in the business.
Well, I don't think he's going to get his throat any better with his lips wrapped around that girl over there.
She's got the lemon juice inside. And ladies and gentlemen, Don Spartan is really punishing Johnny Mercedes now. It gives him a vicious knee to the back of the head. Your head, people don't realize, is pretty vulnerable. Once you don't have it together inside mentally and physically, the match is pretty much over. And you never know what Don Spartan is packing in those tights, because he can use any foreign objects he wants, legal or not.
Yeah, I felt a couple foreign objects from Dirty Don in the past. As you can see here, Angelo Armani taking over again on Gigolo Johnny Mercedes.
Distracting Dan Van Loon again. Don Spartan tries to get Mercedes. Mercedes is walking. Does that mean... Okay, Mercedes is bringing a chair. Now, Black Diamond, this is not, I just got here, this is not a no disqualification match. I don't know if Dan Van Loon's going to let him bring the chair in the ring or if he's just doing that to cause trouble.
He's just copying me. That's what he's doing.
And may I say, he gave some vicious shots to the Widowmaker out there, and that was a match and a half, truly a battle that'll go down in the record books in Ringside Wrestling Alliance.
Absolutely.
Closed fists that Dan Van Loon is not seeing, and now he's going to throw Johnny Mercedes over the top rope. Right there, he hit his knee on the coupling that's keeping our ring together, which I hit as well when I was thrown out by Alan Scott Cruz. This could be the end of the match right now. Dan Van Loon is exercising the count.
Here comes Armani again. This is exactly what I was talking about earlier. He's going to take some cheap shots. The commissioner actually stepping in for once in a match and making sure that that doesn't happen.
And that person walking in front of our camera, a lot of people would like to step into that. Now Dan Van Loon is exercising the count again. Jeff Capone is trying to keep Angelo Armani off. Jeff is saying, come on, Gigolo Mercedes, you got more in you. You got more stamina. But his knee is hurt. That knee is hurt pretty much very often, and he never really gives it time to heal.
Well, I think if he said daddy a couple more times, it might heal a little bit. Oh, daddy.
And may I say that the guys that are handling the music, our intros and everything for all the wrestlers come out, they're pretty much right on the money. They don't get paid enough, if anything. But you know what? The smorgasbords are open late. That's all I know.
What's this about getting paid around here?
Ringside wrestling. Action you can't see anywhere else. We are all over Northwest Indiana.
I'll tell you, the only green I ever see is when I'm in the ring.
He is trying to have Johnny Mercedes give up. He's got, oh, he gives him a vicious elbow to the midsection, another elbow. He comes off the ropes, and Don Spartan gives him a vicious knee. Was that kind of below the normal thing? One, two, and he just it's only a two count. He's got enough stamina to pick it back up. You never know when Don Spartan gives you a knee or a hit, if exactly he has a bullseye in his mind or not, because many wrestlers have not walked away from some of the hits he's given.
Well, I think he's actually shooting for below the belt there. With all the momentum, the ref couldn't really tell there that it was below the belt.
And with Johnny Mercedes, it's hard to tell where below the belt is exactly.
He doesn't even have a belt. I don't even know what we're looking at here.
Matt Hawkins patting us on the shoulder, trying to get the powder off of his hands.
And out of my hair, actually.
Vicious kicks to the midsection. Don Spartan is relentless. He is a specialist. He knows every move, every hold, and even invents a lot. Our cameraman, Sir Lawrence from England, is out there.
I'd really like to commend Larry, Sir Lawrence, as you want to call him, for getting some of the best shots I've ever seen in professional wrestling. Nobody gets as close to the actions as Sir Lawrence.
And nobody gets as close to those stairs as Sir Lawrence.
And nobody ever gets as close to you as I do.
Thank you very much. Now, Angel Armani is distracting Dan Van Loon. Don Spartan's got a choke, got a chain, got something around Mercedes' neck. He is cutting off oxygen, presses oxygen, he needs to finish. He's out, he's winded. This could be it now. And he conveniently puts it back in his tights.
Actually, that's what you were talking about earlier. He's got a whole arsenal in his tights there. I mean, it's okay.
And that's why he and his family are expecting another one.
Oh my God.
You never really know the commentary that's going to come out here at Ringside Wrestling, especially when Matt Hawkins is not here. I can hear the gargling in the bathroom. That either means that he's getting ready for something or that his throat is getting better.
I just feel our ratings dropping at the minute, if that's even possible on public access.
As I said, we are all over Northwest Indiana. Here comes Don Spartan throwing Mercedes into the rope. He ducks a clothesline, comes up over. This is going to be a good reversal. He's got him. He's got him. One, two. But Angel Armani is distracting Dan Van Loon again. Dan Van Loon, the president of Van Loon Hairpieces. And as you can see, he can't find the style yet that fits him exactly right yet. But ladies and gentlemen, I keep that company in business.
Where real men get their hair.
Dan doesn't even know who size Sperling is.
He doesn't even know what size pants to buy. Look at him falling off there. He's going to have to get a bigger belt next time.
Well, he's been working out now.
Oh, yeah? He's doing the 40-ounce curls now, huh?
You know, Dan Van Loon is the senior official here at Ringside Wrestling. I learned a lot from Dan Van Loon. He's a senior, okay,
yeah,
from Matt Hawkins. In fact, he gets discounts anywhere he goes when he just shows him a certain card.
I understand that he's going to grow that hair in the back long enough so it'll flop over the front.
That'll be a different hairstyle for him. But, you know, that's what Dan Van Loon is in the business to do, is to create new hairstyles and new hair pieces. He's trying to get out of the way. There's a snap mare. I even know. He pushes Dan out of the way, comes up, and he misses with an elbow. Don Spartan has been misjudging those a lot lately. I don't know how many more of those he can take. He's choking Johnny Mercedes. Dan Van Loon is trying to break the hold. As I said, Black Diamond, he's missed a lot of those clotheslines, a lot of those elbow drops, rather, and he's not going to be able to do that very much more often without injuring himself.
Absolutely. I wasn't even paying attention, Dave. What were you talking about? I was too busy watching the lady in the red jacket walk by.
That was my mother. Now, he just missed another, you bastard, he just missed another elbow drop. And Mercedes is just trying to muster up enough offense to stay in this.
There she goes again. What a beautiful lady that's walking in front of. We get the prettiest girls coming to these events, I'll tell you.
And you know what? Ironically, she had Black Diamond Rocks on that T-shirt that she was wearing. And may I say that I would be privileged, if not honored, to sing at her wedding.
Well, I think we could actually arrange that, if we talk to the right people. Oh, big slam here. Oh, man.
He got a lot of good height, and he felt all of that flat on his back.
Meanwhile, back in the ring, actually, that big slam's going to take a lot out of Don Spartan. Now, what Johnny's got to do, he's got to get it back together here. He's got to shake off the cobwebs. He's got to take it right to Don Spartan right now. He can't be stalling like this. He's got to take him out right now.
Sound guys, we have any Sinatra you could play to give him a little bit of momentum? he gives him a head into the turnbuckle. They don't have a lot of padding there. They're just for a little bit added protection, but you feel every one of those. He's going corner to corner, post to post, and Spartan comes back with an eye rake.
There comes the chain again. It's going to come into play. Wait, he blocks it. Oh, gives him a right hand.
And he catches the chain in midair. Now, I hope Dan Van Loon doesn't see Mercedes with this.
Now, this is the kind of justice I like. This is what I like to see. I like to see actually people taking it back, giving it back to the firm when they've been giving out to the wrestlers of RWA for so long.
And the lady that just walked in front of us should have given back some of those hot dogs to the concession stand. This is it. The match is over. Does that mean he is disqualifying Johnny Mercedes?
That's the most I've ever seen Matt Hawkins move to ring that bell.
Okay, now I don't know if Dan Van Loon disqualified a vicious fist to the face.
I hope he's not blaming Johnny for the chain. Is that what's happening here?
That's exactly what happened. He didn't see Spartan with it. He only saw Johnny Mercedes with it.
I think he's talking to you, Dave. Either that or you heard my daddy comment. I don't know.
Speaking of watching my mouth, did you see the girl that just walked in front of the camera? Now, Angel Armani is bad-mouthing Jeff Capone. I guess Mercedes got disqualified because he used the chain that Don Spartan originally had. We're going to have to look at the tapes and see if we can talk to Jeff. And he just...
Now that was brutal on the stairs there. He gave him a shot right on the stairs. Here we go. A little bit of justice here. Angel Armani. Well, watch out for Dan Van Loon. He's got a bad leg in the first place. You don't want to be knocking him over.
Johnny Mercedes wants that belt. He's going to hit him with the belt. I don't know what exactly is going to happen. He thinks the belt, the title, should be
his.
That is solid steel on there, ladies and gentlemen.
After what I've been through tonight, even that makes me cringe.
Okay, there's a little bit of justice going on. Please stay tuned for more action.
Good evening, fans. Matt Hawkins here for Ringside Wrestling Alliance. I'd like to update you of our 97 tour.
This world stinks. The
Armani.
Stinks.
Hey!
What?
We're trying to film.
Get some respect
here
on the tag team.
We're trying to film.
Why don't you shut
here.
Your oh, mouth? Will you? Get up here, you piece of garbage. Get up! I'm the tag team champ!
Where's Jeff?
I'm the tag team champ!
Come on,
piece of garbage. Come on!
Hey,
I'm the tag team champ!
Come on,
shut up!
Get him out of here.
Psychopath.
Come on, help him out.
What the hell was that?
Get him help out of here.
Jeez. Animal. Jeez.
Somebody get him a towel. Come on.
Hey, there you go, Larry. Come on.
Okay, fans, welcome back. My apologies sincerely for Angel Armani and his disrupting attitude here. He thinks he owns RWA. You know what? You're the one that acts like you own Ringside Wrestling Alliance. I've got news for you, and so is the commissioner. You don't own it.
First of all, why don't you throw in the towel? First of all, my limousine driver was 10 minutes late. You know how mad that makes Angel Armani? Then this Joe Jabroni here, the promoter here or whatever, comes out and says he's stripping the title. You can't strip the title away from Angel Armani.
He can't strip the title, and he did. So news for you, you don't have any gold.
He couldn't strip varnish off a board. He is not going to strip the belt from Angel Armani.
Okay.
I don't care.
Wait
how
a second.
High
now
I...
we got what? More members of the firm. This
what
is ridiculous.
What the hell just happened here?
Yeah.
What's wrong here? What happened?
I come out here. Everything is late. There's more potholes. holes in Indiana than on this guy's complexion.
Yeah, like, we want to talk about this. It's very stupid. You went in here and all of a sudden you're attacking the commissioner and we'd lose
this?
The tag team
Where's
titles.
The tag team?
You better get it your head straight, pal. That's all I got to say.
Wait a minute,
no,
KB.
All I got
this
to cheap. Say is you better get your head straight.
$3 an hour guy cameraman, he won't give me the respect that I deserve. I'm one half of the tag team champs.
Well, not anymore, and it seems that the firm's pretty ticked off at you.
It seems you just took care of that little matter of being a tag team champ, like I told you. I just took that belt from you. I've had it with you. I've had it with your garbage. It seems like everybody else around here is getting fed up with you. You're done, pal. I just stripped you like a brand new strip floor.
Strip this pile in your face.
I strip you right out of here.
All right, fans, so there you have it. There you've had it. The commissioner sped up with Armani.
What else do you have to say?
People are fed up with you here in Ringside Wrestling Alliance. The firm wants nothing to do with you.
I don't even care about the firm anymore.
Where are you going to go from here, Armani?
If I have to, I'll go, man. I'll knock the firm and every one of your stinking teeth in.
Why don't you go cry in this? You need it more than anybody else does.
Don't you pound sand.
All right, fans, stay tuned to Ringside Wrestling Alliance for more great wrestling action.
And the challengers for the Tag Team Championship, Billy Wild and Derek St. Holmes.
Alright, fans, good evening, Matt Hawkins here, Ringside Wrestling Alliance. We got the tag team titles on the line here tonight. We've got the tag team, Damage Incorporated, Widowmaker and the Soultaker. They both rolled to the outside as Derek St. Holmes and Billy Wild really anxious to gain the tag team titles for Ringside Wrestling Alliance here tonight in LaPorte, Indiana. Fans, I'd like to thank you very much for tuning in. A double noggin knocker, give them both a headache. Wait a second. Up and over the top. Got them both. Comes crashing down. Okay, Billy Wild's excited to be here. He wants tag team titles, and Cruz better watch it or he'll get his face shaved, because obviously he's already ball-headed.
I'll talk to you later.
I'm sure you will. All right, fans. I'd like to thank you for tuning in. We're on three cable systems. Yes, fans, we started on one. Now we're in three. Started at TCI Cable, Hammond and East Chicago, and we've gone to US Cable and Turner Premier. We're all over the place. Watch us on your local public access channel. I'd like to thank you for doing that tonight. All right, fans, if you've been watching Ringside Wrestling, if you haven't, let me update you on what's been going on. Earlier tonight, Angel Armani getting into a dispute, beating up a cameraman, our cameraman Larry, and the commissioner Jeff Capone stepping in and saying, well, you want to do that? I'll play a game of my own. I'll strip you of the title, the tag team titles that you and Don Spartan currently hold, and that's exactly what's happened. And now tonight, two top contender teams are out here, and this contest, the winners will be the tag team champions, as we have the Widowmaker and... The Widowmaker and the Soultaker now. Now, right now, nice thrust kick. He rolls to the outside. Now, wait a second. King Bishop's out here giving Cruz a hard time. Cruz saying he signed him to a contract. Okay, now the referee's exercise a count.
We got the belt.
Wait a second. There seems to be a little dispute going on between Mr. Cruz and King Bishop. Excuse me. Well, nice little kick in the butt there. They're arguing on the outside about the fact that Damage Incorporated have been signed to the firm. All right, the fans are behind.
That's the way it is.
Okay, wait a second. All right, Crew's having a hard time with King Bishop.
He's an idiot. We got the Indiana State.
He's a what?
He's an idiot.
Well, all right. Nice armbar. He's got down the canvas. Now we got King Bishop out here. We got the baldy Mr. Cruz, Smoking Jeff Capone, all three at ringside here. King Bishop giving, I mean, he's really up in Cruz's face about the fact that he signed Damage Incorporated to the tag titles. Tag has been made. All right, they're getting in an argument. The tag title's on the line here. You would think King Bishop is just trying to concentrate on getting the gold, but no, he's worried about the fact that Damage Incorporated signed the contracts to wrestle as members of the firm. All right, Cruz says he signed contract. He's a lawyer of the organization. They're arguing at ringside. Whoa, nice. Snapmare pulls him over. We got one. Okay, there's only a two count. Whoa, and Cruz catching flag. You know, what's going on between you and Bishop?
He's a brain dead idiot. He's upset that I signed these guys. We signed the Indiana State champion. What is he nuts?
Well, okay, King Bishop and Mr. Cruz exchanging words there as far as the golden. Who's signing contracts around here? Nice side headlock up to the corner, brings him down. All right, two very good up-and-coming athletes here in Ringside Wrestling Alliance.
Don't let Bishop touch him if he comes around.
Okay, that's a change. I've got it, Cruz, I've got it. But two fairly newcomers here in Ringside Wrestling Alliance. I know, Cruz, I got it. All right, we got the Soultaker in the ring and Derek St. Holmes up into the corner. Oh, no. All right. Now the Soultaker needs to stay on top of him. That's exactly what he does. Kicks downstairs into the abdomen. Now he needs to make a tag here. Well, so far it seems that Cruz made a good find in signing these two, even though Mr. Bishop doesn't agree.
Mr. Bishop is a moron.
And once again, Mr. Cruz calling Mr. Bishop a moron. And we'll have to see what King Bishop thinks about that. Hopefully I can catch one of these two in an interview before the end of the night. Tag is made. In comes the Widowmaker, and the Widowmaker, formerly Radical Ricky Von Erich, has a change of heart now. Bad guys wear black, I guess you could say. Takes him, nice snap suplex. Excellently done by the Indiana State champion. Cruz is worried about signing the gold. Bishop's worried about, honestly, I couldn't tell you what he's worried about, but he's frustrated at Cruz for signing these two to a contract with the firm. Okay, picks up, looks like he's gonna go for a tilt-a-whirl, slam, and down he goes. Excellently done there by the Indiana State
talked
champion.
To PJ Brown. He talked to
him. All right.
He showed him a Charlie Ward the other night.
Well, these two, Derek St. Holmes and Billy Wilde, are in trouble here. They may be losing their shot at the tag team titles. Whoa, nice leg drop right across the chest. I must say, I like this team of the Widowmaker and the Soultaker. Let's just hope I agree of their ways when it comes time to win or lose a contest. Went for a tag now right there. Okay, a little cheap shot there. And the referee, senior official, great referee, Dave Talbot, trying to back Billy Wilde out of the ring. Billy Wilde needs to do his partner, Derek St. Holmes, a favor and step back out of the ring. All right, fans, if you just joined us, I'd like to once again mention three cable companies, TCI Cable, Northwest Indiana, US Cable, and Turner Premier. You can, Ringside Wrestling Alliance can be seen on all three of them. All right, he goes to the outside now. We got, all right, now, nice. The two baldies up, team of baldies, I guess you could say. Sorry, didn't mean to insult.
Watch your mouth, you'll be bald.
I must commend Mr. Cruz, however, this is the best find he's had since the specialist Don Spartan, which has been a long time. Case, nice elbow smash to the chest. All right, now the fans of LaPorte, we're here at the Pine Lake Hotel in LaPorte, Indiana.
And two of the greatest tag teams Ringside Wrestling Alliance has seen in a long time, Derek St. Holmes and Billy Wilde against Soultaker and the Widowmaker, with, of course, Mr. Cruz out there on the apron. But I'm telling you, these two men, once again, now, okay, Soultaker backs him into the corner. Now he's in no man's land. They've cut it off and have Dave Talbot's distracted there. Billy Wilde not doing his partner any favors here. And Soultaker and Widowmaker, they've cut the ring off in half, and that's exactly what they need to do if they're going to win this contest here tonight in LaPorte, Indiana. And Dave Talbot now finally paying attention to the action. Not his fault, however, because Billy Wilde, once again, as I mentioned, wasn't helping his partner at all. well by distracting Dave Talbot. All right, now Widowmaker's in the ring, sending him for the far side. Excuse me, comes back.
Sunset flip in the ring. We got a one. We got a two. We only got two counts. That's referee Dave Talbot. Nice armbar there. Spins him over. Nice pinning combination. We only got a two. All right, come on. Referee Dave Talbot says we got a two. Billy Wilds on the outside. We got the new Soultaker on the outside. All right, fans in the port once again trying to get behind Derek St. Holmes. He needs to reach over and make a tag. Wait, no, what's he go? Nicely done. One, two. Oh, come on. Close. Referee Dave Talbot once again with a two. All right. He picks him up. He spins it down hard to the canvas. Fans, I'd like to mention something here if I could, as a tag is being made in the ring. Ringside Wrestling Alliance tours all over Northwest Indiana.
And as a boogie-woogie man, Jimmy Valiant says himself, we are the real deal, as a Soultaker backs Derek St. Holmes into the corner. Shots downstairs to the breadbasket. Where's Talbot? There he is. He's exercising the count back there, getting the Soultaker back out of that corner. And that's what Dave Talbot needs to do, as Derek St. Holmes sent for the ride. Nobody home. Derek St. Holmes needs to follow up on top of it. He goes for a backward schoolboy roll, but it may get the job done here tonight. No. Only a two count there, says referee Dave Talbot. Both men down on the canvas. Dave's going to be exercising the count, I'm sure, here. And both men finally get to their feet, as a Soultaker looks like he has a little bit of an advantage here. As Billy Wild, real anxious to get in the ring there. And Derek St. Holmes, he's going to get it together and get him in there.
As a tag is made, in comes Billy Wild. Hits him to the top of the head. Close fist back and forth. These two men, we got a freshman in the ring. Sends him. Comes back. Nicely done. No cover there. Referee thought he was going to go for the cover. There's the cover. Two. Only a two count, referee says. Excuse me, fans. Whoa, wait a second. Oh! Brings him in the hard way. Sends him to the far side. Nice drop kick. All right, as he steps outside, Billy Wild working over, doing a good number here on, oh, wow, the Widowmaker. All right, fans. He pulls him back into the corner. Derek St. Holmes trying to get the fans here in LaPorte, Indiana, behind him. He was careful there. He almost broke his leg. He needs to be careful. He climbs upstairs. He's on the third floor. Elevator going down. Nice double X handle splash. We got a cover. Two. Come on. All right, we only got a two count. It was close, though, fans. It was close. All right, we got all four men in the ring. Okay. Referee. Referee's exercising the count. Ducks down. Sunset flip. One, two, no, only a two count. Derek St. Holmes and the Soultaker on the outside here. Oh, sends him right into the wall. Okay, wait a second. They're going at it outside. Wait a minute, what's going on here? Mr. Cruz with the briefcase. Oh, come on, ref. Where's the referee? Oh, Talbot, come on. Oh. No. Oh, come on. Oh, come on.
Baby, don't even come near it.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners and new tag team champions, Damage Incorporated, the Soultaker and the Widowmaker. Okay, collar and elbow tie up in the ring. Nice side headlock there by Mr. Spartan. Spartan and King Bishop, members of the firm, even though right now there's been deception going on. Well, I don't know what you may want to call it. You got
Well, Mr. Bishop Cruz is out here. Wait, okay. Mr. Cruz has two contracts that were signed by Damage Incorporated. You're not pleased by this.
Stepped over the line. There is no way that Mr. Cruz is going to have these guys associated with him. Angel pulled some garbage today and lost the tag team titles for Don. This is ridiculous. The whole thing is ridiculous. No, it is not going to happen. Don't even be reporting stuff.
All right, well, fans, it looks like the firm may be kind of, sort of falling apart, losing its foundation in that being Mr. Bishop and Mr. Cruz. It just, as Mr. Spartan right there showing how smart he is, ring presence, and the Paralyzer going to the outside. All right, the fans getting behind the Paralyzer here tonight in La Porte at the hotel. Forearm shot to the back. Oh, into the canvas. All right, Paralyzer thrown back into the ring. Don Spartan gonna work him over some more, I'm sure. All right, forearm shots to the chest. All right, fans, and now Spartan getting backed off the ropes by the referee, Dan Van Loon. All right, and the Paralyzer's on the outside yet again. Okay, Don Spartan, once again, he's a great athlete, as is a Paralyzer on occasion. When the Paralyzer wants to shut up and wrestle, as the t-shirt says, he does just that. But until then, you know, he kind of wastes time and watches the paint dry. Even though the fans are behind the Paralyzer here tonight in La Porte, Indiana. All right, handful there, illegal move, referee being very lenient. Now the Paralyzer has held his share of tag team titles, of all titles. He's been the RWA Heavyweight Champion. Him and Don Spartan are former tag team champions. And they held the tag titles for many occasions for long periods of time. But however, the firm had different game plan and had a different road to go down than the Paralyzer wanted to, and they separated in hard ways, you could say. Okay, and Spartan with two handfuls of hair. All right. Right, fans, our third contest here in La Porte. We got about two or three more after this intermission that we're going to take shortly after this. All right, nice roll up there. All right, I'd like to thank once again our hometown, Ringside Wrestling Alliance's hometown of Hammond, Indiana. All right, the referee's exercising the count. Gonna stretch out that leg. That'll hurt him real quick. Now, Spartan needs to stay on that one move, on that one leg, excuse me. All right, he he's got him in a figure four. Okay, now Spartan. What's Spartan gonna do now? He's got the move on. He's working on that one part of the body. If you don't have a leg, you can't stand. If you can't stand, you don't have the strength to carry someone, slam them for that matter. So ultimately, you may lose the contest. Fans, I'd like to take this short, brief opportunity to thank all those behind the scenes of Ringside Wrestling Alliance who make things happen, sometimes an unthanked job. But Dave Talbot doing a wonderful job with camera work and refereeing. Lucky Larry Lothario doing the camera and also doing ring crew, you know, Ringside Wrestling Alliance. We'd like to think it's a family, but the ones who operate behind the scenes, we operate, we put up the ring. You know, we're all around good guys. So to those, I'd like to say a special thanks and keep up the good work, no matter what anybody higher up may say. And Spartan being caught upstairs on the third floor, slams him down hard to the canvas. And the Paralyzer needs to stay on top of him if he wants to win this contest and climb one step closer the ranks in Ringside Wrestling Alliance. All right, now Blaine chokes there. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're trying to break the... All right, come on. Somebody's got to get in here. Someone's got to save him. Okay, wait a second. We got some problems going on. We got some problems going on here. The new tag team champions are in there whooping on the Paralyzer. Okay, wait a second. Oh, and a double noggin knocker. Whoa, Cruz and Bishop getting into it. Soultaker and the Widowmaker roll to the outside. Fans, stay tuned to Ringside Wrestling Alliance. I'll have to do this overdub. I gotta go to the ring.
What in the hell was that?
John. I don't know.
Who in the hell released salt and pepper bean poles coming out here?
That was Sergeant Pepper and the Hedgehog for Man, but it's okay.
Who saved me?
Don
Spartan!
Don Spartan! Did you get rid of them guys and help me out? Hey, guys, looks like we got a new bald beanpole tag team. I want to talk to you guys for a minute. You guys want to see him come over here and talk to me? Hold on, keep it down. Now Don, me and you have been beating the hell out of each other for the last 2 years. 8 years before that, we were best friends, partners, and you trained me. And now, after 2 years of beating the hell out of each other, you watching my back? Is that what I'm seeing? Do we have, not so much as we're best friends, but do we have a common enemy, as it seems? Now, half the scars on my head are from you. And every time you've been to the hospital, it's been from me. So that should tell you something, that we're the toughest SOBs here in ringside. We were tag team champions twice. We were both heavyweight champion, back and forth with each other for the last 2 years. Maybe these people want to see the three of us reunite. You guys want to see something like that? Huh? I'll tell you what, when we were champions, we couldn't be beat. Hold for hold, no one can touch you. In a brawl, I'm the baddest son of a bitch here. Amen. The two of us together are unstoppable. Now I'm willing to forget about the butt kicking you just gave me. You forget about the butt kicking I just gave you. And we go out here and kick some big, bald, tall, skinny, skanky hyenas. Because I'll tell you what, if you'll get in this ring and be my partner, there is no one on God's green earth that can beat us. Amen. What do you think, people? You want to hear? Go for it. Let's see what they have to say.
I've been bringing guys in here for the last 3 years to put you out. Nobody's done it. We've been friends a long time. A little parting of the ways happened. But I'll tell you right now, if Don's willing, I'll be glad to be in your guys' corner.
Yeah. Oh!
It's up to you, Don. People, what do you think?
Go for it, come on, come on! Get the belt, 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 get the belt.
Tag team champion and a tag team belt.
They're tag team champions?
Yeah!
We gotta get them to get the belt!
There is one loose end that still has to be taken care of. Mr. Cruz, get your ass out of here.
Cruz, you fall!
What are you doing talking to that idiot? We have spent 2 years trying to put him out of wrestling, and
three.
You're sitting here making kissy face with him? Have you lost your mind? What are you doing?
What am I doing?
What are you doing? Yes, are you deaf as well as stupid?
Oh,
you're the body guy.
Mr. Cruz, you're fired.
What?
You are
what?
Fired.
You cannot fire me.
I'm going to let you go now. Hey, if these people are going to stand behind us.
Yeah.
If he's going to stand behind us after all everything that's gone down here. You've embarrassed us. You lost your hair.
I'm embarrassed us. You're in the ring with the embarrassment.
You look like a... I'm looking at you right now, and all I think about is Easter. You know? You lost your smile. I'm telling you right now, just a little bit with your tooth. Right now, you would not even be involved in professional wrestling if it wasn't for me.
Yeah.
You would still be running around with your buddies in the 7-Eleven buying the gay magazines, you know? I'm telling you right now. But you are. You're like Jeff Van Gundy. Pat Riley makes a team, and you think you had something to do with it. As a matter of fact, you even look like the guy to me.
No,
so if you want to bring these little clowns in here and go against a real team, we'll be glad to take your money.
Yeah!
These people stand behind us, and I know you guys don't like me, and I really don't care, but I'm telling you right now, we're going to take these guys out.
Tonight, I'll tell you what. You want the match? We got Madarioville coming up right here. We got the match in Madarioville. You want it? You got it. Because they're going to come in here, and they're going to kick your ass, and they're going to kick your ass, and I'm going to kick your ass while we're there, and we'll be done because I'm tired of it. I've done all the work for the last 4 years. You sat on your butt behind the commentating table.
You're throwing those towels to Mr. Cruz over there so we can fry into it.
It's over.
I'm very proud to say the Paralyzer and Don Spartan reunited. And everybody better look out.
Look out! Yeah!